Hello, and welcome back to Control. Last episode, unexpectedly to me, we actually finished the main story. I thought I was going to have time to do all these side quests, and then it was like, no, you just go directly into it. I'm like, okay, cool. So, yeah, we'll start with Old Growth, and then we'll keep going down the list. I believe Old Growth is also the one we got first. I want to wear this outfit. I turned my nose down on this one, but let's try it. Why not? Okay, so it's in Central Research. Let's fast travel. I think I know where it is. It's that like little moldy place I think we found downstairs. I think that may be where we're supposed to go. All right, here we go. Oh, I've learned that. I forgot about that. I did that because it would make it easier to get to the secret locations. Oh, fuck's sake. Oh, right. I'm also invincible. Who gives a shit? Hey, what the fuck? I'm not even trying to play the game properly now. I'm just like, I just want to do the missions, man. Oh, for fuck's sake. Yeah? That's absolute bullshit. Wait, where is it? I'm still, trying to attempt to play the game properly. I'm just like, fuck that shit. Okay, yeah, that would have killed me. You're my friend now, alright. Okay, I have to admit that's pretty fucking cool. Okay, you're my friend now. And where's that enemy? Alright. You guys have fun there. So I don't think I can go in there. No, actually I can. Cool. Yeah, I think it's this way. Ooh. Okay. Spicy. You know, like, why did you unlock that mission when you don't have levitate? It's a bit counterintuitive. The pit. Okay. Ooh, that's... We landed in the bathroom. Any documents for me? Anything for me to read? Okay, there's something to power nearby. I don't like the sounds I hear behind this door. Are you friends? Oh, you're friends. Hey guys, all right.
Excuse me, are you lost?
That was the most British accent I have ever heard in my life, and I live in Britain.
Do you normally barge into people's private workspaces?
She clearly doesn't know who she's talking to.
Shouldn't you be in a safe room? Why? Because of those hiss things the Rangers keep going on about. Haven't you people sorted that out yet? The situation down here could spell doom for the Bureau.
You mean this mold?
Correct. Perhaps you could help me. I require samples of various mold strains, and the mold has made the environment far too dangerous for me to fetch them myself.
Really? Mold samples? I thought this could spell doom.
It could, and it will. Whoever you are.
Okay, whoever you are.
We need to find the source before it spreads too far.
And these samples will do that?
No. Samples of 5 unique strains, when blended properly, will allow you to travel deeper into the pit where I've pinpointed the approximate location of the source of the mold.
Okay. So what do these samples look like?
Similar to the one on my table there. I've made a list of the samples I need. Here. You'll find them throughout the threshold.
I'll take a look. My name's Jesse, by the way.
I'm sure it is.
Alright. Fucking bitch.
I assume you'll be staying with us until the mold is eradicated.
Indeed. Until I find a permanent resolution to this pesky fungus business, I'll be here. Perhaps even beyond that, seeing as you are quite understaffed. Though, I hardly have a say in my own comings or goings. Your oldest house won't open the exits until those hiss monstrosities are cleared out.
Glad to have you along for the ride. Will the mold be under control anytime soon?
We were barely containing it with weakly controlled burns. Just look at how it has spread after a few days of non-interference. It's beyond the threshold now. The floodgates are open.
So that's a no.
Americans.
With Darling gone, I'm putting Emily Pope in charge of the research sector.
Oh.
Are you okay with that?
Perfectly.
That didn't sound...
Excalibur from the stone, and now decree as you see fit, O Queen.
Okay.
What a true meritocracy we live in.
Glad to hear it.
You know, you're kind of a bitch. You do realize it was her that sent us to save you, right? Like, what the fuck?
I had a dream. Or something like one. Darling was there. He told me something, but I can't remember what. I think he's gone.
Right. Well, he's never where one expects him to be, is he?
I mean, gone as dead.
I can finally stop writing these tedious reports that I'm sure he never even took the time to glance at.
Okay.
If you speak to him again, can you tell him I... I hope he found what he was looking for.
I'll try.
I should be getting back to work.
Okay.
I'll see you later, Rhea.
Dr. Underhill, if you please.
I'll call you whatever the fuck I want. I'm your boss, bitch. Mold threshold. Active threshold mold research. So you want to know how my mold research is going on, Casper? Here it is. Microscopic organisms similar in appearance to blank construct the architecture of the mold. I do not understand if these blank are the original disseminators of the mold or are bitten by some fungal infection. The mold is the most prolific and durable organism I've ever seen. I theorize there is mold source located somewhere on our side of the threshold, rooted there to accelerate growth in our dimension. I refer to this yet unknown source as Mold 1. The mold produces an enticing aroma to encourage human consumption of itself. It propagates in the chest cavity and quickly subsumes the entire body. It's in control of motor functions. This behavior was not observed when I first arrived, which means the mold has adapted to our presence, targeting our biological imperatives as a way to spread. It is truly an ingenious little thing. A full report will be ready soon. Keep your slacks on. Okay. Oh, fuck. No! Fucking god damn it. Now I have to go look. Oh, the side projector is it? Let's look at that. Side projector. The object is a blank with a vertical tray. The object creates blank. See Dr. Jolling presentation. The only blank to successfully produce this effect resulted in the capture of blank. See Dr. Jolling presentation. Object has not been successfully bound. The periutility of this object does not require binding. Background discovered when the Bureau responded to blank, CWE24. Many of the accompanying blank were blank, see files B6 and B7 for details. The entirety of the blank was transported to the Bureau for examination to find additional slides or other altered materials. Yeah, they got the whole thing back. Oh, I get a photo now. Oh, okay, I'm director of the Federal Bureau of Control. I'm the video game boy. I'm the one who wins. Thresholds Utility Research. Dr. Darling's recently penned essay titled Blank contains some glaring omissions that I feel I must shine a light on. Firstly, the entire premise of the essay is that the quarry threshold is beneficial to the Bureau. While the mold is actively hostile, to use his words, we cannot determine the worth of these dimensions and their life forms using bureaucratic definitions. Secondly, the mold is much more beneficial than some rock. If the blank creating the mold were reconfigured in their purpose, the structures they could build would rival the greatest skyscrapers. The mold resistant to various strains of diseases we've attempted to introduce could be derived into blank. Yes, admittedly, this application is more difficult than picking up a rock and gluing it to a wall, but I pause to wonder when the Bureau lost its eagerness for a challenge. Wow, she really had a chip on her shoulder, as they say. You know what? Fuck you. Like, glam rock song. Underhill, checking in. Hello, Raya. How is it going down there? Enjoying the mold so far? Setting back into life at the old FBC? I also wanted to ask how your coffee with Emily went. She's a star on the rise, incredibly bright, extremely intuitive. But I want to hear what you thought of her. I think you two could be very good on a project together, could learn a lot from each other. Let's get together and chat about it soon. Anyway, sorry for the interruption. I'm sure you can't think of anything besides the mold right now. You always were a woman of focus. I always admire that about you. Talk soon, Casper. Was he always so informal in his messages? Also, she said... Oh, is that what the samples look like? Are you okay? Okay. I like how mold type B is fecal matter. I wonder if any would be here. Oh, I also just noticed that. Oh, fuck off. I didn't notice it before. It probably activates the elevator. I don't see any mold. It says near the pit. Well, this is also a bathroom, so the bathroom one would be near here, surely. No? I'm just trying to figure out if any of them would be here in this area. Or if they all would be past the store. No. I saw something in there. Oh! I don't think you want to taste the mold. Pink flamingo supplement. Agents notice a transient commonly found outside the entrance of the bureau headquarters would carry the item and loudly claim to be responsible for the lack of inclement weather. The frequency of these claims attracted the personal interest of Dr. Darling. In interviews disguised as casual conversations, the transient reported that the item gives me clouds when it's hot and sun when it's not. An event of note occurred during a heavy downpour when the vagrant was witnessed performing a possible ritual with the item CPAI-1372 for detailed observations. Dr. Darling reported a wait of blank seconds before the rain stopped. The vagrant was seized the next day. After blank, he was found to possess no utilitarian abilities, I'm guessing, and was released. The item remains in bureau custody under suspicion of altered status, though this still has not been proven. All known variations of identification formulas have failed to elicit a response from the item. I'm surprised this wasn't anything. My friend now.
Are those people?
That would be the assumption. Okay. Oh. Oh, fuck. Jesus. Where did they shoot me from? Oh, I see him. I see him. Holy shit, that scared the living shit out of me. You're so far away. Jesus Christ, they were so far away. That genuinely surprised me. I guess I can't step on this. Yep. Right. I see one mold sample. Oh. Okay, so that's the pit one. That's probably why I need the medication for this bad boy. Oh, I hear something. I see another one. Right. Picnic basket procedure. A Bremen basket AI-54 UE. Item to be stored in a BlackRock paneled cell. Keep away from lab animals when not in use. A simple wicker basket with cloth lining, no food items inside. The item produces an hypnotic effect that solely affects non-human animals, forcing them to congregate passively around the object. Animals from every genus and species that have thus far been tested are successful. Single-cell organisms do not appear to react to the effect. So it's a basket that makes you be Snow White. Appendix 697. Item was taken to a forest upstate for testing. Results of the test provided contradicting data as some of the attracted animals exhibit hyper-aggressive behavior. The exercise unfortunately resulted in blank, blank, so someone dying. Further testing should be restricted to more low-risk animal species with medical staff on standby. Interesting. Right, there was more this way, right? Oh, it just connects here. Well, they hurt me. Ooh, restrooms. This is a big place. Okay. You know, she's like, oh, the movie, it was Shawshank Redemption last episode. It's because the first line she says in the game is literally comparing her life to Shawshank Redemption, or a scene from Shawshank Redemption. I didn't know the name of the movie because I've never seen Shawshank Redemption, so I didn't make the association. But she did. Alright. There's a lot of toilets. Toilets. But that was still very funny. That she was just randomly like, Shawshank Redemption, that was it. Like, the whole fucking game, she couldn't remember the movie for the speech she made in the beginning. And then at the very end, she's like, Shawshank Redemption. Lab. Ooh. Alright, who's gonna fucking spawn? Oh no. I hate this. Whoever created this is cursed. Thanks.
Building shifts occur at random and without warning, but with the Bureau's cutting-edge technology, we can stabilize the oldest house. Safe employees are happy employees.
Okay.
Stuck in your room for 3 days, Topher. Too bad you didn't have your book with you. Or any food. An remember, kids, when you feel the floor deviate, it's already much too late.
Like, the purpose of the Threshold Kids show was to help my brother with acclimating to the space he's in now. How is that gonna help any child? Like, that's even... That traumatizes a child, if anything. Like, how... like, I know the Bureau approved it to try to get... Oh. And they spawned again? God damn it. Also, I didn't go to the bathroom, so let's go. Where was the way to the bathroom? Because I went a different way to get here. Oh, hi. Oh, fuck me! That's still scary. Again, I can't die, but that fucking still scares me. Alright, fucking toilet we go.
Gross. Underhill is gonna owe me for this.
Staircases and fresh corpses. I like how I can't die, like I physically can't die and it still scares living shit out of me. Hi, bud. Again, the pathing of explosives in this game is great. That's a staircase right there. Oh, also, I was looking it up the other day. And this starts a very funny story, but... basically, my partner is a big fan of you know, Alan Wake 2 and Control now, because he's watched Jesse Cox play. He hasn't played himself. He doesn't play a lot of games now. Currently. Oh, nice. But I saw a clip of Jesse Cox talking with someone who personally knew, what was his name? Sam Lake? The guy who writes Alan Wake. And, like, he was doing the dance in the Game Awards and stuff like that. And they were talking how brave it was and stuff like that. And he was telling me, he told me, looked me straight in the eyes and was like, you know he's dead, right? And I'm like, what? And he's like, yeah, he's remember the news about the actor from Alan Wake that is dead? And I'm like, oh, that's him? But they're talking so happily about him. Like, what do you mean? And he's like, yeah, I guess, you know, you don't want to be negative in a podcast. And I was like, oh, that's sad. And he's like, yeah. And then I was like, it sat with me for like half a day. And I was like, this doesn't sound right. So I looked it up. And then I sent him a text message saying, you fuck. It wasn't him. It wasn't Sam Lake. Sam Lake portrays physically Max Payne, but it was the voice of Max Payne that died, which is the voice of Zachariah Trench, which is very sad because he did such an amazing job. But yeah. But we are the... A funny... It's not really a funny when someone's dead now, is it? But we did have a sort of curious thing with that. Oh, I'm just missing the corpses one. Okay. Oh, yeah. Claim that reward. Kill enemies in the container setting using abilities. I mean, sure. I have spin mode. I can do that now. Also, do I have enough to... Oh, yeah. Yeah, I need some more untapped potential and remote thought. What was that from? Oh, I won't see that. But remote thought is from containment. I haven't been to containment that much often, so that would explain it. I do have a mission to do spin, so let's do spin. Oh boy. You... Ooh. That's 100% gonna fucking kill me, eh? Alright. Ooh, so what do I want to put in this? Accuracy? Accuracy is not bad. Headshot damage. Ammo cost while levitating. Energy gain from headshot. Accuracy. Rate of fire. Oh, there's two different rates of fire. I guess one is exclusive for spin. Ammo cost per shot. Well, I'm gonna do that. And then rate of fire. Let me do by type. C speed 56. Go fuck yourself. health 30%. Screw you. Okay. Launch energy costs. I have one for every almost fucking except two. Cost minus 18. Alright. Oops. Sorry. Why have I not been using this weapon? My god. I love SMGs. Oh. Sounds amazing. Okay, can I get that fresh corpse one? Oh. Oh, these poor boys.
This looks like a good one. That's all five samples. I should get these back down the rail.
Right, let's go down. Oops. I hear a lot of noise. Which doesn't bode well for me. One of them is just going to be around the corner to scare me. Why not? Right, never mind. Let's give her those samples then.
You look like a woman with mold for me.
Exactly.
I found L5. But I kind of wanted to eat them. The mold has that effect on some people. Likely due to the fact it's not actually mold or even of this dimension. I suspect it is the result of two incompatible molecular structures, one dominant, coming into contact. I call it mold or fungus because it's closer in appearance and behavior than anything else we know. Except perhaps bacteria.
She reminds me of my old biology teacher.
Did you happen to meet any more members of my ranger detail? I didn't see any rangers.
They were dead.
Mold people.
The dead ones. Yeah.
If you found mold people, you found my rangers.
Oh.
I refer to the creatures as hosts. They, like other unwary agents, succumbed to the appetite. But that's nothing for you to worry about.
You should have warned me.
What I'm about to make with these samples will make the lower level perfectly safe to traverse. It has the added benefit of immunizing you against the pit's toxic spores.
I feel like I should ask to see your credentials.
Yeah, I know, right? My god.
That didn't take too long now, did it? Ingest this pill, then go and find the source of the mold. Only there can we begin to understand how to stop it.
Take a mystery pill because a rude lady in a hazmat suit tells you to. Great idea, Jesse.
Oh. Honestly, did you want me to wrap it in cheese?
Yeah, I did.
Just the smell. It stinks in here now.
Good. That means the pill is working. The worse it smells, the safer you'll be. Now go. Find the source.
Okay.
I'll see you later, Rhea.
Dr. Underhill, if you please.
I'll call you whatever the fuck I want. I'm your boss. Oh, shut the fuck up. She is annoying me. Are things gonna respawn? Yep. Yep, they did. Nothing else seems to have. Like the ones, the shooty ones. Oh. How wonderful. Can I get one of these bad boys? All right, thank you. Can I get another one? Thank you. Like shooting fish in a barrel. And then we just go to the pit.
This must be the pit Underhill was talking about.
Oh, yep, fully immune. Down we go. I might as well just use all of this at my disposal.
Ramsey, Ranger Captain, Note 7.25.
Let me open in collectibles.
Ramsey, Ranger Captain, Note 7.25. Underhill sent us down this weird-ass threshold looking for whatever's making all these vegetables sprout. I will say this,
no. Delicious. Don't! No!
Underhill sent us down this weird-ass threshold looking for whatever's making all these vegetables sprout. I will say this, it smells delicious.
Why? Why would you do this to yourself? I don't know which way to go. There's two ways. Come on. Okay, so this is where... Fuck off. Oh, I exploded myself with that. So there's that way. There's this way. What? 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 Is that? Oh. I don't like the music is going on. That's never a good sign for me. That's actually quite a bad sign. Kind of weirdly reminds me of the song from Halo. Like Covenant Dance and shit like that. Oh, fuck off. Okay, cool. Why is there a bunch of... Whenever I open one of these, something spawns. Okay. Okay, whenever I fucking mute my mic, just undoes everything. Alright. Oh, that means there's a boss battle, doesn't it? Why else would it?
Is that the source? It's kind of pretty.
Oh! Nope. Wow, Jesus Christ, okay. Come on. Okay, I have to wait for it to attack me. And then shoot him in the thing. Yeah, got it. Fuck off with that shit. Okay. Oh. Fucking okay. Oh, Jesus. Fuck, okay. Wow, okay. Wow, this boss fight is amazing. And I'm so bad at this game, but that's fine. You're supposed to evade that. I see. That's fine. Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, Jesus. Oh, wow. How are you supposed to actually do this? I mean, I can survive this because, you know, I'm basically immortal, but... How are you... I guess... evade? Wow, this is so difficult. Holy shit. I guess it's a proper boss fight. I did like the first phase. Once the floor start being this, that's kind of... I hate it.
I need to stop being surprised by all the weird shit in this place.
Yeah, once they did the floor is lava bit, like, that's... You lost me there. It was cool until then. I like how I can't even have an actual map. Because then, like, how... Like, I guess you're jumping in from place to place and you have to keep moving and that's it. But Jesus Christ. I'm glad there's an invisible mode here. Oh.
Oh, so good.
Oh no. Oh well. He's well and truly dead. Rest his soul. Isn't that's where I am right now, okay. Active threshold. Wasn't that two ones? I have to say, that's brave. Awesome power. Right, I kill the bolt.
You've returned, I see.
I cheated, but it's fine.
And you're not sprouting mold from your eyes. I take it that means my pill worked. Now tell me everything. Did you find the source? You did, didn't you? I found a big angry plant. Like, gigantic. I killed it. You killed it!
Yeah, obviously. Yes!
I could have learned so much from a live specimen. Her concern is touching.
I know.
It's too much. Here, I brought you a sample. A piece of the innermost mold. You're not such a lost cause after all.
Oh, I hate you so much.
So different, even superficially. Another stage of growth, perhaps. Please, no more stages. You'll be pleased to know that cutting down the creature at the source has already resulted in a notable cessation of the mold's rapid growth. You've bought me time for further study. So what now? I'm glad you asked. While you were busy in the pit, a number of mold hosts were sighted beyond the threshold. They managed to sneak out without the rangers noticing. There's a reason I didn't send Steve and Andy to find the mold source with the others. These vagrant hosts must be eradicated as soon as possible. The mold can still be spread by their overgrown bodies. Any idea where they went? The hosts I've observed are not a sprightly bunch. Here are the reports I've received. They'll help you find them. I'll go take care of them. Good.
And do be quick about it.
There's a nice way to say that.
I know, right? Like, I'm your fucking boss. Ooh, 4 points.
Dr. Underhill, if you please.
Oh, shut the fuck up. I actually genuinely hate her. He's such an annoying prick. 69. Okay. All right, get rid of that. There you go. I got some more corrupted samples, untapped potential. So what do I have now? Oh, there's like, kill some more mold in each. Okay. Well, one of them is in central research, which I shouldn't be that bad. Especially because I can... Yeah, okay. So let's find that central research one, because I can just deal with it now. Yes, of course. Why not? Why wouldn't shit spawn? Oh, fuck's sake. The fucking secret one. I absolutely hate this one so much. You are the most annoying piece of shit. Yeah? I know you're there. Mm-hmm. Come on. Fuck's sake. Oh, this would be where the mold man went. Hi, bud. Is it the only one? Okay. So there's probably three of them. So I just have to find like the little traces of mold. All right. Oh, we'll try to finish off this one with that. Oh, that's just the radio. Were there any here? Yes. Hey, bud. Oh, you're gonna listen to some music? I mean, I can't blame him. It's some good fucking music. Okay. Third room's probably higher levels, no, surely. Oh, I see him. I see the fucker. Hey, bitch. How did you get there? Where are you? Where are you? Oh, I wonder if it's... Yeah. Oh, fuck. I was trying to make it into the... Oh, fuck off. I might put, like, one shot, one kill at one point, because... Alright, bye. Where's the other one? Fucking one behind me. Alright, there you go. Well, first of all, let's upgrade our abilities. Seize! Seize. Alright. I think there's 2 points. Ooh, except the ground slam damage one. I'll save my points. I'll save my points. Okay, being shot somewhere. The fuck, how'd you get here? Okay, I'm still trying to just figure out. Is that in luck and probability? Oh, I can actually go in there. That's like ritual division, that's no longer like... I'm gonna have to look it up. Alright, fuck off. I'm going to Central Executive. Fuck you. I'll have to look it up. Let me actually start doing that here. Is it mold removal? Oh, you have to break the window. That's how you get there. That's what the game's trying to teach you. That's so smart. And I'm so dumb. And I'm so sorry. Alright, let's have a look here. Do some last cleanup. Alright, and we had a lot of collectibles, and I don't know if I saw all of them. Oh, yes. I remember this now. Hell yeah. I love this so much. Fucking phone. I need to find out if this is on Spotify. Did you say Jesse's dying tonight? Nobody knew her name, but she turned up just the same. I couldn't understand what he was saying. There was a knock on the door, a thump on the floor. The party turned insane and she called out her name. As she walked in looking like dynamite, she said, "Now come along, boogaloo through the night." And by the way, she was moving well, dynamite. She not with all she's got. She's got the whole town lighting up dynamite. Nobody quite knowing what to do, wrong or right, but they all know Jesse's dynamite. That's right. Okay, yeah. Yeah. That's funny. That's so funny. All right. What was the final message? Oh, his final message. Yeah. I don't understand why he was naked. That part I didn't get.
I'm Dr. Casper Darling, and this is my final message. It's not the end. But after this, I won't. I exposed myself to Hedron Resonance fully. It is. It's changing me.
What did happen to him?
I've been shown so much. Slidescape 36 was where Hedron stop the spread of another. It's terrifying. It really is. It's another source of resonance. Trench was exposed to this other. It will now spread. I've done everything I can to stop it. The Hedron Resonance amplifiers. I don't know if it'll make a difference. I won't be here when it happens. I should have told him anymore. I'm being sent one more lesson. Something wonderful, I think.
So the thing I don't know is if this last message was before or after the Hedron protective suit thing that he built. Like, did he get the message after doing this final message, and like then he built the Hydran protector gear, and like that's why we have that? Like, I'm not sure. But yeah. What was that, the outline?
My reflection trapped in the darkness of the coffee I nurse. The rain turned the lights of the city into a mosaic on the windows. The day's paper lists all the things wrong in the world. The list grows longer by the day. The difference between the morning and the night. Coffee. Whiskey. No other difference. The alarm goes off at 5 a.m. It feels like I just closed my eyes. It's dark. I sit up on the bed in the gloom. I get up, I shower. The driver waits for me downstairs, takes me to the oldest house. An old man stares at me in the car window. It's raining. It's dark. Late at night, he brings me back here. It's not a home. It's a room where I sleep in, waking up just as tired as I was before going to bed. Endless grind.
Geez, that's very positive and for our life going forward. The East has removed Silent from the astral plane. You have proven beaten the not you. We like tolerate you very much. Thanks. You are prepared and prepared for what comes next. We will speak again. In the future expansion. Wow, okay. Good work, Victory Director. Just to set up that it was going to be DLC. That's cool, I guess. But yeah, like, Darling was supposed to be the opposite of Trench, even though in the beginning they're painted as working together. While you are also the opposite of your brother, because your brother was influenced by the Hiss, as well as Trench, similar to Trench. And both you and Darling were influenced by Polaris. So I like that contrast. Like, I generally like that, but we never actually learn what happened to Darling. Like, he's just like, this is my last message. You never find a dead body. You have no idea where he went. I'm guessing that could be answered in the DLCs. I'm just speculating. I'm not complaining. It's just like, where has he gone? All right, let's decide what to do next. I'll probably still do the mold removal. And then maybe do the enemy within. That sounds good. But yeah. Yeah, and after that, we'll start with the Foundation DLC first, which is that one. And then we'll do the Alan Wake one. But yeah, that was really good. I'm looking forward to doing the rest of all of these DLCs. But yeah, I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.